All right, folks, it's been about a month, so you know what that means. That's right, it's time for a new tier list. It's time for us to tell you where we think each character stands and for you to get mad about it. Kidding. Y'all have shown our videos a lot of love and we appreciate it. We're not here to drag down anyone's mains, we're not here to bring anybody down, we're just here to give you another tier list to think about and discuss. So before we get started, let's talk some basics. This tier list is for patch 5.0, so it's gonna have all those good DLC characters in it this time. If you want more details about what exactly the patch changed, just check out our recent patch notes video that's linked in the description. For now, we're just gonna focus on the characters. And as always, we're starting with the low tiers. Now remember, there's no shame in having your character in this tier. We're not saying you should drop them, nor that you can't win a tournament. Ultimate might be the most balanced Smash game ever, and pretty much every character can create an upset. You'll see even the lowest ranked characters get some good placings every now and again. Speaking of the lowest ranked characters, let's get started with our E tier. But before we do, if you're looking for tips to help you get your low tier hero on, look no further than ProGuides.com. We've got guides for all sorts of characters and skill levels, whether you're just getting started or now breaking into the top 8. We even have a personal pro course available by MKLeo, the best player in the world. Your character may very well be an E tier, and that's okay, but Pro Guides and MKLeo are here to make you an S tier competitor. You know what? We're gonna start with the Plant Gang again. Okay, we see you out here placing high in tournaments. For anyone who hasn't taken notice, Brood, a Smash player out in Japan, got second place using the plant, and that wasn't just some local either. He took out big names, like Gackt, Shutone, and Kamehameha. Piranha Plant's specials are surprisingly good in neutral, but this Veggie villain still has low speed, mediocre recovery, and a weight class that makes him all too easy to combo. Piranha Plant's neutral is looking better than ever, and we're just looking for a few more good tournaments before we move the Leafy Lad up. If we're talking about characters that did shockingly well in Japan, we gotta talk Little Mac. At that same tournament, a Little Mac main did serious work and made it all the way to 13th. Pretty good stuff. But just like with Plant, one win isn't enough. We need a trend! Mac has even less of one than Plant, and honestly, he's got bigger problems too. Little Mac has the worst air game in Ultimate, and you need an aerial game in a platform fighter. And remember, if you go to a tournament, people can ban Final Destination. Mac might just be the easiest character in the game to edgeguard and camp, so we're keeping him in low tier. But hey, don't worry about him too much, he's used to being the underdog. Let's talk about somebody else who's used to being an underdog. Or, well, actually just a dog. Let's talk about the character that is a literal dog, Isabelle. Everyone's favorite civil servant is still stuck in low tier, despite some small buffs and some big upsets. We've seen that Isabelle can be lethal in the right hands and can do some work against zoners. Isabelle has good zoning and counter zoning tools, but the problem is that she dies quickly, she's kinda slow, her recovery is exploitable, and she just doesn't have a lot of good tools in her kit. Characters with any decent amount of speed or disjoints can easily work around her traps and proceed to punish and destroy her. Speaking of characters that are somehow slow and lightweight, there is Kirby! Sakurai has abandoned his child! He has abandoned his boy! Give Kirby the buffs, Nintendo, and let him go to top tier. I guess I'll keep dreaming. Unfortunately, this crowd favorite hasn't gotten buffed once since Ultimate's release, and so he stays in bottom tier. Despite being lightweight and having multiple jumps, Kirby is slow and easy to edgeguard. He doesn't have a lot of threatening moves on the ground or in the air either. All of his decent options aren't really safe either. Down throw relies on grab, while dash attack and forward smash have high end lag. Ultimate's just a bad game for pink blobs in general. That's right, now we're talking Jigglypuff. Puff has gone from the scourge of Spaceys to the scourge of... let's see here? Oh, very few characters, wow! Puff still has some of the good aerials and the good recovery she had in Melee. She can still punish characters with bad recoveries. The problem is that her rest kills way later than it used to, and she just can't edgeguard the way she did in Melee, man. Since Puff is just as light as she was in Melee, that basically throws her game plan out the window and drops her all the way to the bottom of the tier list. Last, and honestly maybe least, we've got Bowser Jr. Bowser's weird children round out our E tier yet again because of their weird mishmash. If you looked up wonky in the dictionary, Bowser Jr.'s picture would be right next to it. This character has a weird mix of zoning and approach tools that don't add up that well in neutral. Bowser Jr.'s main tool is juggling, using their up special to take stocks off the top blast zone. However, beyond that, this Koopa Kid has a super linear approach that involves mostly special moves and aerials that aren't too tough to beat once you figure them out. Okay, now we're on to the D tiers. These are the characters that could end up in mid tier with a bit of love from Nintendo or from Labrats and Hidden Bosses. Let's kick things off with everyone's favorite character, Sans Undertale. Wait, Me Gunner.
Yeah, it's still Me Gunner, right?
Anyways, Me Gunner had some great news earlier this month. Toby Fox and Nintendo would let Me Gunner cosplay as Sans from Undertale. In one fell move, Sakurai and Toby Fox unleashed a plague of Me Gunners onto Quick Play. Bad news is, Me Gunner is moving down in our tier list, from C to D. Me Gunner has terrible representation on the PGR, with barely any notable players maining them. On top of that, the meta has moved away from Gunner too. There were nerfs to shield damage in a previous patch that hurt Me Gunner's ability to pressure opponents. Plus, there are so many better projectile characters that players have learned how to dodge and beat projectiles in general. But hey, now your opponents will at least feel like they're gonna have a bad time. If you're wondering where Me Gunner's results have all gone, it's probably into Samus and Dark Samus, the OG Gunners. This bounty hunter's got a lot of weaknesses, but she's also got some strong players on her side like Advo, YB, and Joker. Here's the deal with Samus. She's got a great advantage state and can pressure people really well at the ledge. The problem is, her disadvantage is pretty dang bad. She's heavy, yet falls slow, so she's very easy to combo. She has some landing options, but she's still easy to pressure, and she lacks raw kill moves, so she can't punish over extensions very well. And just like Gunner, those shield damage nerfs hurt her pressure game pretty badly too. You know, Robin's a bit like Samus, if Samus were a Fire Emblem character. The both of them have a unique playstyle, strong franchises, and aesthetics that draw players to them. Robin has some pretty good competitors maining her, like Scorpio, Jewel, Dath, and Nairo when he's feeling spicy. Robin also has some useful tools to trap characters on the ledge and push their advantage. The problem is, Robin's style lacks versatility and can get linear. Robin relies on lots of shieldable specials to win, and lacks raw kill moves without their trusty Levin sword. Since we're talking about zoners, let's talk K-Rool. Wait, is he a zoner or a heavy? Or both? Whatever he is, it ain't great. King K-Rool can do some pretty fun tricks with his blunderbuss to trap opponents at the ledge. He can also get some surprise free wins in neutral with his armor. However, at the highest level, K-Rool is super exploitable. You hit him on the side with his recovery, bait his moves out, and figure out his projectiles, and you'll have a nice pair of crocodile skin boots in no time. King K-Rool mains can make some stuff work with his diverse kit, but it's tricky against top tiers like ZSS or Pikachu. But hey, at least K-Rool's nemesis isn't doing much better. Donkey Kong is D tier too, despite the fact that you know him well and that he's the leader of the bunch. Like K-Rool, Donkey Kong is heavy and slow, making him combo food that's easy to whiff punish. DK also has one of the most easy to punish recoveries in the game. It doesn't go far, and it makes his hurtbox bigger. In the early days of Ultimate, it appeared DK was bigger, faster, and stronger too. Maybe even the best member of the DK crew, but now Diddy Kong's looking better than him. Worse than that, Bowser looks better than him. DK is a heavy grappler archetype, like Bowser, but Bowser just does a better job than him. However, that makes us think DK might not be as weak as he seems. In time, we expect him to finally come back and kick some tail. I mean, move up to mid-tier. If we're talking about heavy grapplers, we can't leave out Incineroar. Incineroar has some notable mains like Magister, but Incineroar's got even more notable problems. Incineroar is basically what a Smash Heavy has been for a long time. A hard hitter with bad recovery and bad neutral. Incineroar can get early kills with his revenge mechanic and his throws. The problem is, he can get gimped early and comboed by everybody. Other heavies have the same strengths, but stronger, and the same weaknesses, but less weak. That puts Incineroar in D tier. Alright, let's just get all of the likable but low tier heavies out of the way now. Ridley has great kill power, but a super punishable recovery and a huge hurtbox that's easy to combo. Whoa, that's weird. Anybody else feel a bit of deja vu there? Anyways, Ridley's got some cool, weird combos, a solid projectile, and a great neutral air. But he's also got a lot of end lag and big wings that clip above the ledge so you can edgeguard him for free. That's bad news for the Space Dragon. Speaking of dragons, let's talk about the Half Dragon. Corrin is one of the truly unique Fire Emblem fighters. Unfortunately, that uniqueness hasn't given Corrin a lot of mains or notable placements. Corrin has some good tools in neutral, and combos, but just doesn't have a lot of damage output. With less speed and a worse recovery, she's like a poor man's Sheik, and Sheik's no top tier, but she is a dragon with a lot of cool hitboxes. Speaking of bad recovery, let's talk about Dr. Mario. Unlike Corrin, Dr. Mario has no trouble getting kills. He has tons of moves that take stocks early and do big damage. His problem is that his recovery is very rough, even when using his down B to get some distance. To make matters worse, the doctor is also super slow. I mean, look at the size of those pills. The dude is carrying an entire CVS in his lab coat. Unfortunately, slow is one of the worst things to be in Ultimate's meta, because it makes it harder for you to get follow-ups and chase down elusive characters. This low tier's problem isn't recovery, for once. Villager actually looks good on paper. Their frame data is pretty nice, and their recovery and neutral tools are solid. Players like Kept make good use of these tools too. While Villager's wonky style and good tools and neutral fit lots of players, they're just not that strong in any one area and doesn't beat out other characters. A lot of other characters can zone or trap better than Villager can. A lot of other characters can box and scrap better than Villager can. A lot of other characters have wonky, good tools like Villager does, except they make for a more clear and easier to execute game plan. The Pits have the same issue as Villager. They're just not that great in any area. They've got some nice disjoints and solid speedy moves. They've got multiple jumps to help edgeguard and some interesting specials, but they don't have a crazy advantage state, or tool in neutral, or even that good of a recovery. While the recovery covers a lot of distance, it's slow and doesn't have a hitbox. The Pits feel very average, and in a game like Ultimate, that actually makes you low tier. Most characters are better than just average. Then there's Meat Brawler, the other character that just doesn't have a lot of juice. Outside of being able to look like Guy Fieri or One Punch Man, Meat Brawler isn't that exceptional. Meat Brawler has a few nice moves in neutral, like their command grab and shot put. However, Meat Brawler doesn't have the combos or the speed to pressure opponents well and put a bunch of damage on them. Meat Brawler's kinda just okay in general, though they do make for a fun, goofy character that can have some creative interactions in neutral. Alright fellas, that's the end of the low tiers. That's D and E tier, for anyone keeping track. Guys, when we get to this part of the tier list, we're pretty critical because we're talking about low-ranked characters. But that doesn't mean we don't think you should main these guys. Every character in Ultimate has their strengths, and no one is truly unplayable. We just think these guys will struggle in bracket more than most characters, and we're telling you why. But if you love how they play more than any other character, that's alright. After all, everybody loves a low-tier hero, and you know what else? Everybody also loves people who subscribe to Pro Guides. So especially if you enjoyed this video and are looking out for the next part of our tier list, hit that subscribe button right now here on YouTube. Thanks so much for watching, guys. I'll see you next time.